Hello everyone. Welcome to another episode from Exploritage. In this episode, we're going to see Halebidu, the capital of the Hoysala dynasty. Halebidu was the capital of the Hoysala dynasty in the 12th and the 13th century. Halebidu was originally known as Dwara Samudra, which means entry by ocean. Hoysalas were ruling from Velapuri or Belur from the banks of the Yagachi River. When Vinayaditya shifted the capital of Dwara Samudra in the 11th century, he built a canal to channelize water from Yagachi to the new capital. A tank was built and the Hoysaleshwara temple was later constructed on its bank. Halebidu is a Kannada word meaning ruined city. This name is given because this city was ruined two times by the invaders in the 1310 and 1326 AD respectively. When the Vaishnava complex, with the most ornate of Vishnu temples, emerged in Belur in 117 AD, it obviously converted Belur into the most enviable religious center in the Hoysala kingdom, even overshadowing the metropolis, Dwara Samudra, or present-day Halebid. This apparently provided some provocation to the wealthy and influential Shaiva community of Dwara Samudra, who lost no time to muster resources and skills to construct a monumental structure for Shiva in the capital. There is little doubt that the initiative leadership and even a major chunk of the resources for the construction of the temple came not from the ruling king, as in the case of Belur, but from the merchant aristocracy, the prominent of whom were Ketamalla and Kesarasethi. This large temple was ready around 1120 AD. Halebid's Hoysaleshwara, Shantaleshwara, and Kedareshwara temples and Belur's Chanakeshwara temple are artistically similar in many ways. The Hoysaleshwara and Shantaleshwara temple is laid out on a double plan, that is Dvikuta Vimana or two shrine, almost as if two temples were joined side to side. As you can see, the shrines are named after the temple king Vishnuvardhana Hoysala and his wife Queen Shantala Devi. The temples enshrine Shivalingas and many of the sculptures are Shaiva. Unlike Belur Chanakeshwara temple, although Vishnu images and themes are also present. Both shrines open to the east and rest on the usual Hoysala star-shaped platform or Jagati. There are no gopuras or towers. The two shrines have a hall or mantapa in front and are connected, giving a large and imposing view of the hall. Individually, these are smaller compared to the shrine in the Chanakeshwara temple of Belur. We will cover these two shrines and then proceed for another beautiful temple complex where complex of Jain temples and the Kedareshwara temple are located. This is around 500 meters from this temple. While Belur Chanakeshwara temple is highlighted on its interiors and the figurines, Hoysaleshwara temple is more to watch out on the exteriors and the ornaments. You will also observe that the temple complex is not as vast and elegant as Belur. Only other structures that you see are two nandis or bull temples in front of Hoysaleshwara and Shantaleshwara temples. Its construction was taken up probably soon after or even before the temples at Belur and were completed in about 5 years. Interestingly enough, it was named after the ruling king, Vishnuvardhana Hoysaleshwara. The sculptors who created this beautiful temple were Kalidasa, Damoja, Ketana, Ballana, Revoja, Harisha and others.